You're watching RollerHockeyTV.net.
I'm Skyler LaHore, Rick Rat Hockey, member of Team Mission Axiom, and you're watching RollerHockeyTV.net.
Hi, I'm Tommy Neer, the assistant category launcher of the Rollerhockey Team. This year, we introduce the Roller Hockey product offering. Continuing our R&D pursuit on Roller Hockey technologies, we look to provide the standard of warm and insulated insulation, transverse surface that we plan on the rink, and pivot to slow the goalies down. Slide tech allows for the increased battery performance, allowing the goalies to The concept behind the slide product was to eliminate the goaltender from having to hop from post to post across the crease. The slide is a helpful tool that will give the goalie some semblance of being on ice, where it's allowing him to get some slide ability across the crease to get into position much quicker.
We have accomplished this by strategically placing slide bars in areas of amplified friction or resistance. So what does this mean for goalies? Improved lateral movement and mobility, plus a positionally sound goalie, equals higher save percentage and lower goals against average, which means more W's.
With the new Inhaler Series goal pad, you will be making saves you never made before.
This is Stephen Campbell with the Breakaway Bullies, number 17. I'll see you out on the Major League roller hockey floor. Come get some.
Ladies and gentlemen, joining me right now, a man who has many hats. Now, again, I could just stand here and announce position and position and position, but I'm with Rob Coggin right now. And, Rob, we're going to talk a little bit about what you're doing in the sport. Rob is involved in so many different facets of inline hockey. It's fantastic. Let's first of all talk about the National Collegiate Roller Hockey Association. What do you do exactly with that, Rob?
Well, Doug, my position with the National Collegiate Roller Hockey Association is Director of League Operations and Officiating, which basically Director of League Operations position. What I do mostly for that is my main job actually is handling the national championships. It goes into a lot of facets. I have to find locations. I have to put the whole thing together. But it also involves making sure that our regions are up to speed on what needs to be done, helping them, assisting them during the season, get them what they need, and making sure that, you know, I go out in the field, I'm visiting all the regions, looking at the teams, so when it comes down to time for the selection process, we have a better idea of where teams stack up and, you know, how they've been doing through the season.
Now, over the years, that's really a tedious process, but how much time does that actually take you? I mean, you're evaluating teams, you're making sure that divisions are set, you're making sure that teams basically have parity when they come to meet each other so we don't see somebody overpowering each other. How often do you travel for that?
Well, I a lot more than I'd like to. I'm actually on the road usually 6 or 7 weekends out of the year just at the regional level. And then on top of that, our national championships takes, you know, that's usually about a 2-week thing for me. So I'm on the road quite a bit.
And can you give us any information this year on the national championships? Or is that top secret right now?
Well, it's not top secret. I can let a little bit of the cat out of the bag. We're going somewhere warm in April where college students aren't going to mind going in April. Tell you that much. We don't have a contract signed, Doug, and so what we do is we wait until that contract signed before we actually release the location. I'm hoping within the next couple of weeks from now we'll be able to have a full announcement and get moving forward.
Well, if that has anything to do with Amarillo, has just expanded this year, as you know, we're going to Palm Beach, Florida. Major League Roller Hockey has expanded in that area. I'm not going to say anything further, but I just got a big smile out of Rob. So great news there, and obviously now let's talk about USARS. You just got a fantastic position with USARS.
I did. USARS has done what many, I think, would think is a wonderful thing in the sport. We've USARS, and I say we now because as a USARS employee, have really made a commitment after having been somewhat dormant for a while in the sport to really come back as the national governing body and provide that leadership that the sport really needs. You know, as most of you know, USA Hockey decided about a year and a half ago that they were no longer going to maintain their roller hockey program. And at the time, they basically handed the whole thing over on a silver platter and said, we're going to support and we're urging all of our leagues to support the national governing body, which is USA Roller Sports. The nice thing about that is that a lot of the animosity, I think, that had been there between those two organizations kind of just fell away at that point as a natural course of things. And then, by last July, C.J. Yoder, who many of your viewers definitely know who that guy is.
If you haven't heard of C.J. Yoder, you've been living in a cave.
CJ Yoder and I have been hired full-time by USA Roller Sports to basically build for them a hockey program, a la what USA Hockey has for ice and what they had for roller hockey.
That's fantastic. As you know, CJ Yoder is probably the most decorated athlete in inline hockey, whether it's FERS winning a championship there, double IHF, he's won a championship, PIHA, and some exciting news a little bit. Let's get into PIHA. I know CJ couldn't be here with us, but CJ this year on the Colorado Thunder has brought in three players. The first time a PIHA team has brought in foreigners to come and play, and obviously you work with CJ. What's been the excitement around all that?
Well, I mean, the excitement is clearly there. I know that they've had their first couple series of the season, and I was there for one as a referee, actually, so I had to stay impartial and unbiased on this. But that being said, those are always good series, and the first series of the year was against Parker, and from my perspective, those are always great games to work because there's an intensity level there between those two squads. There's not a lot of love lost between those two, and when they get together, it's always really good hockey.
Fantastic. Our guest has been Rob Coggin. Again, Rob now with USARS, helping to develop a national program very similar to what USA Hockey did. He and CJ Yoder pioneering. You know, we can expect nothing but great things out of them. And also, this year, looking forward to the national collegiate roller hockey finals in a very warm, sunny place. We'll keep you MLRH viewers updated as to where the location is when Rob announces it. Other than that, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be right back after these commercial messages.
I'm Travis Snow. I just beat the Super Deeker, and you're watching RollerHockeyTV.net.
Hi, this is Christina Caney from Zamboni Company and Zamboni Kitty Rides. This is from RollerHockeyTV.net.
Hello, I'm Garnet Alexander. I'm the skate developer for Mission and Bauer Roller Hockey. When you think about what we wanted to do this year, is we wanted to capture airflow into the skate. So we have lots of ventilation in the toe box, lots of ventilation in the quarter. Now when you think about it, when you're skating, that skate is attacking the air in front of it. So as that toe box comes cutting through the air, air is flowing in through here. Now when you look at the way that we configured the vents on the side of the quarter, they're angled out so that air comes out. So you see, as that skate is flying through the air is flowing in through this toe cap and out through the quarter vent. Now at the same time, you'll have airflow through the tongue as well. We have openings in the tongue so that air is coming in to cool off the top of your foot. So front of your foot, side of your foot, top of your foot, all of it has active ventilation. We also made changes to the chassis. So we've removed a lot of material. Now this is all material that wasn't really needed in the chassis. So by removing this material, we're saving weight. So we've got the lightest chassis we've ever made. But we haven't had to sacrifice any performance because it was all material that wasn't really being used. Think of it more like a bridge structure. We have material where it's needed, and where it's not, there's openings.
Because we're making such a bold statement with the vented quarter, with the vented toe cap, we knew that our overall design theme, it needed to show that we're confident in our product. If I had one word to describe the inhaler series, I would say it's fresh. We have a smaller tendon, it's an asymmetrical tendon, the flowing Mission logo on the side, the true vented tongue, the new design, the new profile of the chassis, the fact that you can personalize that quarter, you can take your little marker and color in your little initial or your number on the quarter of your skate. We've thought about everything on this skate. We've tried to put everything we could possibly put into this skate, right down to the textured eyelets. It makes someone pick it up and they can, I know the players appreciate those little details. Or when I design this skate, the whole time I'm thinking, feel the flow, it's going through your head. And I think we captured that with this skate, with this line, with the inhaler series.
Светлана from Russia.
I'm Irina.
Смотрите RollerHockeyTV.net.
The biggest saves of the week, to go to RollerHockeyTV.net.
Steve Stalk, head coach of the Houston Venom. You're watching RollerHockeyTV.net.
When I'm on the road, I always carry the little black card, the MLRH Players Association card. Don't leave home without it.
Pascal Martel, I'm the product design manager for Mission and Bauer Hockey. The whole design of the glove was inspired by the Aeroflow concept, you know, the wind reaction at high speed around the body of the player. We really wanted to have a vented product here, so all the lines and the design elements were designed around that concept.
Building on our previous success of our T-Series gloves, we've taken our aggressive Mission style coupled with our ventilation focus to bring to you the new Inhaler series of gloves. With new foams, new roller hockey construction techniques, we will bring true ventilation to the glove category and continue our momentum from the previous season. This year, the Grip Reaper Palm gets further advanced to increase breathability, durability, and function.
The new Grip Reaper Palm is totally insane, you know, just breathe onto that palm and you'll feel instantly the cooling of the vent that it offers, you know. For me, it's a 10. It's totally a 10. By its bold design, by its technology, by its colorway, the blocking and everything, you can really feel the flow with that glove.
Hey, I'm Nick with Rink Rat Hockey. You're watching RollerHockeyTV.net.
Thank you.